Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In this lesson, I will show you the use of quick selection tool and magic wand tool. So let's select the quick selection tool from here and select any object from the background. You will just choose this tool and increase its brush from here like this. You can also increase or decrease the diameter of this tool from the square brackets from your keyboard, right square bracket to increase or the left square bracket to decrease its diameter. And when it's done, then we will just drag like this to define the edges. As you can see, within a few seconds we just got our selection, but we have some issues with this selection. We have to fix it. To do that, we will just click here, or also you can, when it has the plus sign, you can hold Alt from your keyboard, and when it shows the negative sign, you can just drag to redefine the edges like this. So when it goes inside, then we will again just releasing the Alt, we will just again drag like this to make the adjustment again. We will also correct this areas holding the Alt, and here is an issue. We will make it smaller and a little bit more, and hold Alt from your keyboard and drag here. So we have some areas inside. We will again releasing the Alt from our keyboard, we will again drag from here to redefine the edge like this. Let's correct this one. So I think that's quite good. So after selecting like this, we can copy this. So now you can use this object anywhere you want. It doesn't contain any background or anything. So in this way, you can make this kind of selection and use them anywhere you want. Also, if you want it in a new canvas, then you can just click this layer, and when the selection is done again, you will press Ctrl Shift C from your keyboard. That copied this shape, as well as it copied the dimension currently it's containing. So if we press Ctrl N from our keyboard, that are the width and height that it contains. Now if we click OK and paste it here, then you can see it just fits here. That's because of the command Ctrl Shift C that copies your areas as well as the dimension of that object or element. You can also uncheck this background, and you can save it as a PNG image to use it later. So that's for the quick selection tool. Let's see the magic wand tool in this new document. So we have another image here, and when you have a uniform background and the elements it contains have perfect edges that separates them from the background, so in those cases you will just click on the background, and you can see within a second you got a great selection like this. You can also fix this issues. Just going to the quick selection tool, we will correct this like before. Hold Alt, then redefine the edges like this. Let's correct here. So let's consider it's done, and as you can see, currently we have selected the entire background. But if we press Ctrl Shift I from our keyboard, that will make the inverse selection. That means currently it selected everything excepting the background that was selected previously. So in this way you can make inverse selection of any selection that you have. Let's correct here. If we make another copy like this, we can also press Ctrl T and go to Edit, Transform, Flip Vertical, then we can use it like this. So in this way you can make selections using this quick selection and magic wand tool. It works like a magic, and in some cases these tools will not give you 100% accurate results. So in those cases you will use paint tool to make everything manually, and in the next lesson we will see that. So thanks for watching this video. Hope to see you guys in the next lessons.